Dear friends and parents, myself Vimpana, I am studying in 1st PUC in Alpha Pre-University College, KR Nagar. Today, in this session, I am going to give you some basic information about NEET. So, NEET is an entrance exam for students who take the combination of PCMB for the 11th and 12th standard. So, what is NEET? National Eligibility Cum Entrance Examination. So this is an entrance exam for students who wish to do medical or who are interested in medical field. So in NEET, there are of two types, NEET UG and NEET PG. NEET UG means NEET undergraduation. And NEET PG means NEET post-graduation. So this NEET undergraduation is an entrance exam for the students who have passed their 12 board examination with minimum 50% of marks and wish to do their undergraduation courses like MBBS, BDS, etc. And coming to this NEET PG, so this is an entrance exam for the candidates who have passed their undergraduation courses like MBBS, BDS and wish to continue their further education by doing MD or MS. And this NEET exam was being conducted by Central Board of Secondary Education till 2018. But from 2019, this exam is being conducted by NTA. So this NTA means National Testing Agency. So this National Testing Agency is an Indian government agency and it was approved by the Union Council of Ministers and was established in 2019 to conduct the examination for higher institutions. And now coming to the pattern of NEET. So in NEET there are 180 objective type questions. So there are 180 objective types questions for which there will be 4 options. For example, you think this is a question and you will be having the options A, B, C, D. So you will be provided a OMR sheet and you should tick one right answer. You should not tick, you must mark one right answer. That means you should shade, okay? So this will be like this, it will be there. And so as I told you, there will be 180 objective type questions and there will be 4 options and you need to mark it on the OMR sheet. You need to mark the answer on OMR sheet. So out of these 180 questions, 45 questions from chemistry. So chemistry 45 questions and physics 45 questions and biology 90 questions. So chemistry 45, physics 45 and biology 90 questions. And in this biology, 45 questions from botany and 45 questions from zoology. So here you can see 50% of your NEET questions are from biology and remaining 50% includes chemistry and physics. And one question consists of 4 marks. That means chemistry 45 questions for 180 marks, physics 45 questions for 180 marks and biology 90 questions for 360 marks. So totally you need to answer this 180 questions for 720 marks. So you need to answer this 180 questions in 720 marks and the time limit is 180 minutes. That means hardly you'll get an average of 1 minute to answer this 180. To answer the one question, you'll get an average of 1 minute and to answer 180 question, you'll be having the timing of 180 minutes, that is 3 hours. And there is negative marking also. That means if you mark one wrong answer, then your one mark will be deducted from your scored marks. For example, you think you have answered all 10 questions. All 10 questions are right. And for 5 questions, you have marked the wrong answers. At that time, you will get, I told you one question consists of 4 marks. So you think you have answered 10 questions, 10 right questions. So you will get 10 into 4, 40 marks. And 5 questions you have marked the wrong answers. So you will have minus 5 marks. And 40 minus 5, totally you will get 5 marks. So this is about negative marking. So it's better you don't go with the questions for which you are not 100% sure with the answer. Only try to mark the answers for which you know, for which you are 100% sure. And now coming to the eligibility. So as I told you, for NEET UG, a student should pass its 12th board examination with minimum 50% of marks, and he should be 17 years old. And to write this exam, general category students should pay 1,500 rupees, and OBC or economic weaker section, they should pay 1,400 rupees, and SC/ST they should pay 720 rupees. And if everything goes well, then exam will be conducted in the first week of May, and there will be a registration process from January to March, and in December we'll get a notification. But now due to corona, exactly we don't know when the exam will be conducted. And one question is, when should I start my preparation for NEET? So the answer for this question is, you need to start your preparation for NEET examination in 11th standard itself. Because see, NEET question consists 50% of 11th standard concepts and 50% of 12th standard concepts. So you need to balance both your college studies as well as your preparation for NEET exam parallelly. So, and the best source for your NEET examination is NCRT test book. So there is no other test books better than NCRT for your preparation. Because whatever we'll be having in our NCRT test book, same thing we'll be having, but we'll be asked indirectly. We'll have indirect questions. So you need to mainly focus on the NCRT test book that you will study in 11th and 12th standard. And we'll discuss more about it in later sessions. Thank you.